Fierro Mexican Grill on Rideout Row was inspected on December 20th. The inspector found chorizo on the prep table at 52 degrees and pico mix at 51 degrees. There was also an unlabeled chemical spray bottle, dirty plates in storage, a rusty knife, and grilled chicken on the steam table at 117 degrees. The inspector says the workers took care of the problems that day. Fierro scored a 75. It was a similar story next door at Dipwich Sandwiches, inspected the same day. The inspector found an unlabeled chemical spray bottle, raw chicken in the cooler at 48 degrees, dirty plates, and a rusty knife. The inspector says workers took care of the problems during that visit. Dipwich scored an 80. Baumhauer's Victory Grill on Memorial Parkway was inspected on December 4th. The inspector said the reach-in cooler temp was just over 45 degrees. The hot water in the hand sink only heated up to 93 degrees, and while cooking wings, the inspector said the chicken temperature was too low. In a follow-up visit 5 days later, Baumhauer's took care of the hot water and heated the chicken above 200 degrees, but hadn't lowered the temp in the cooler. Baumhauer scored an 85. If you've cruised through downtown Huntsville, you've likely caught a glimpse of this corner eatery. Melt is known for many things, among them a glorified grilled cheese sandwich. And managers here say that's exactly what they're going for.
We are upscale comfort food place, sandwich, anything that you can melt cheese on, we've got.
Melt was started in Birmingham in 2011 and came to Huntsville in July, building a restaurant on the ground floor at Holmes and Jefferson.
They love the food, they love our wine list, they love that they could bring their dogs.
Melt offers several appetizers, 12 different sandwiches, a bar, a large patio, and party games.
To spend time with each other, they're off their phones, they're interacting with each other, laughing, having a good time.
After 6 months, Hurt said this downtown sit-down sandwich bar is getting a warm reception. In their last inspection, Melt scored a 94. For restaurant ratings, Joel Porter, WHNT News 19. Connor's Steak and Seafood at Bridge Street was inspected on December 5th. The inspector says one of the kitchen hand sinks was being used to thaw out food. The cooks removed the food. There were also plates found in storage with food particles on them. The plates were sent back through the dishwasher. Connor scored an 85. Sonic Drive-In on West 72 in Madison was inspected on December 12th. The inspector saw a worker handling cheese and cooked hamburger meat with bare hands. There were also no paper towels at two hand sinks, chili in a container left sitting out, and popcorn chicken in a warmer at around 123 degrees. In a follow-up visit, the problems were corrected. Sonic scored a 73. Firehouse Subs on University was inspected on December 11th. The inspector found ham in the reach-in cooler around 50 degrees and residue in the ice machine. In a follow-up visit, while the cooler temp was lowered, the ice machine hadn't been cleaned. Firehouse scored an 86. Anyone who ever told you you can't take it with you probably hasn't had lunch at Au Crepe. The eatery at Stovehouse opened 3 months ago, offering something sweet or something savory.
Huntsville is so diverse. Melting pot, people from all over the place. Most people accepting all the new concepts, you know, exciting about the new concept.
Owner Jim Shook came to the U.S. from China to become a sushi chef. He first opened Chop Chop in Huntsville, then turned his attention to crepes, normally considered a breakfast food.
We use rice flour, which is gluten-free naturally, and when we're cooking, when we're making it, so outside will be crispy, so it won't be fluffy with salt.
Au Crepe's menu includes crepes with fruit and yogurt or meat, fish, and vegetables.
But with the crepe, you can carry around. This is this whole concept of actually just outdoor mall.
Au Crepe is relatively early to the party at the expanding Stovehouse. In their last inspection, Au Crepe scored a 100. For restaurant ratings, Joel Porter, WHNT News 19. Logan's Roadhouse in Madison was inspected on December 4th. The bar and grill was written up for having steak and pork near 50 degrees in the cooler and ribs on the prep table at 84 degrees. The inspector says the restaurant was also missing a temperature strip indicator. In a follow-up visit, the problems were corrected. Logan scored an 80. Bar Louie at Bridge Street was inspected on December 5th. The restaurant had cups, bowls, and pans in storage with food residue. There was also a cracked bin and tuna in the cooler at 60 degrees. Workers rewashed the dishes, threw out the bin, and adjusted the cooler to 33 degrees. Bar Louie scored an 84. BJ's Brewhouse at Bridge Street was inspected on December 6th. The eatery also had plates and containers with food residue on them. There was also chicken and pepperoni in the cooler near 50 degrees and mozzarella cheese at 60 degrees on the prep table. In a follow-up visit, the problems were corrected. BJ's scored an 80. There's a new wine bar in Jones Valley that, as the name would imply, is starting to take off. Flight Plan was started by Jim and Belinda Taylor, who had never owned a bar before, but they say they know good wine.
Jim just had an epiphany, you know, hey, we're a flying kind of town here in Huntsville. So the two seem to go together perfectly.
A wine flight includes four different wines from all over the world.
Argentina, Spain, California, and Italy.
The Taylors opened Flight Plan on Carl T. Jones just before Thanksgiving. The bar includes a lunch menu, and Jim is in charge of the kitchen.
We are fast becoming famous for fried deviled eggs.
In their last inspection, Flight Plan scored a 97. For restaurant ratings, Joel Porter, WHNT News 19.